This conference will now be recorded.
So item categories. So we have discussed right in the previous session that is a sales document has a structure. So what is the structure of a sales document? The structure of a sales document is it has a header, item, and schedule line, right? So in the last session, we finished discussing about the header. Today, we will be discussing about items, that is item categories. That means how a item should behave in a sales document. That means whether you should charge for that item or that is a free goods, whether you need to trigger a purchase order, whether you should have a schedule line or not. These are all things, how it would be controlled for that particular material using an item category. So that we'll be discussing today. So every different process has a different item categories. It's very important for you to remember all these item categories. There will be total close to 40 item categories. So you see this? So in total, you'll be having 40 item categories. No option, you have to remember every item category. Because if you remember the item category, then only you'd be in a position to like get that particular field controls. Okay, so every item category for every process you have to remember total 40. So it might be a difficult in 1 or 2 days, but at least a week you can try. Definitely you'll be remembering it. Okay, but you have to remember and you need to memorize every item category. Okay, so every process, inquiry, AFN, quotation, AGN, standard order, TAN, cash sale, BVN, like this, every process has its own item category. That's how system knows that what kind of item it is, whether it's a quantity contract item or a value contract item, or this is a credit memo or a debit memo, what kind of item it is, that system will be identifying by this item category. So how an item category will come into sales document, that we discussed in the next session, we'll discuss it. There are a couple of parameters, right? So how is the, where is the control of this item categories? Transaction VO V7. So let's go to the transaction VO V7. And as I already told you, there is item category determination, how these item categories will be coming into sales document, basing upon 4 parameters, right? So that item category determination, we'll see it in the next session. So today, let's discuss about the controls in the VO V7, how it's being controlled. So what data comes at the item category? Anyone? We already discussed earlier. What data will come at the item category level?
Material master
and CMIR and VOV7, not customer master.
VOV7, okay.
VOV7 data, whatever we are supposed to discuss now, right? So let's go to VOV7, item category controls. So before going to this, let me tell you 2 things. So your success getting into the SAP SD, you'll be facing some hurdles in learning the concepts. The first hurdle is item category. You need to cross this because see, 40 item categories you have to remember, and there are lots of control fields there in the item categories for every process you need to remember. So this will take little time, but don't worry, it's pretty easy. Matter of 1 or 2 days extra, that's it. This is the first hurdle you need to cross to proceed further. So as you pass, again, you will be getting one more hurdle called as pricing. But don't worry about these concepts. It's pretty easy. Maybe 1 or 2 days extra it will take. But you have to cross them. Because many people drop out of the training, not mine actually. So from whoever comes from other trainings, they tell that, Praveen, I learned up to item category, but I could not understand. I don't know what's happening. So I just dropped the training. So I'll tell you very clearly. That's the reason I'm telling you in advance. Don't worry. This is pretty easy, but matter of time. Maybe 1 or 2 days extra it will take for you to remember, memorize it. Because there are lots of contents here, right? So let's go to the item categories. So standard item category is TAN. This is the standard item category, TAN. So you have lots of item categories here, AFN, that is inquiry, AGN, quotation, BVN, cash sale, G2N. Credit memo, G2N, credit memo, KMN, quantity contract, WK1, value contract, right? So lots of item categories like this. So you need to remember all these item categories. Then only you will be knowing what is the functionality of that field in that particular item category, right? So just practice, you'll be pretty easily remembering it by seeing the screen. It's a pretty easy, but it may take little time, 3-4 days, not a week, okay? So now let's discuss the controls. First, let's go to the standard item category TAN. So item type. So item type tells system that what kind of item it is. There are some materials which you sell to the customer, okay? Let's say X material, you sell it for $100, okay? X material, you sell it for $100. But when you have a scenario in business that if customer buy X material 100 quantity, you will give X material 10 quantity as free. How system will know that this 10 material is free? Because see, the same X material, which is $100 each, you are selling to customer. But the same again, X material you are giving free to customer. So how system will know for which item I need to charge and for which I should not charge, right? That all will be dependent upon these controls. Okay, coming to the items, item type, that means what type of items we have. So TAN is the standard item. That means for which you charge, you sell this to the customer and you take money from the customer. There are other materials, TATX. TATX, text item. Text item. How system knows this is a text item when it comes into sales document? By seeing item type B. But what is a text item? See, whenever you buy a mobile phone, you buy a TV, fridge, laptop, whatever you buy, you will be getting a user manual, right? Is company selling that user manual to you? Anyone? Will company sell the user manuals?
No.
By default of the product, you are getting delivered. That means, see, you buy a laptop, within the box itself, you'll have that particular user manual. So it's not like, say, company says that, okay, you take the laptop today, tomorrow I'll give you the user manual. No, right? Any user manual comes within the box package, right? That is text item, and you should not charge for text item, right? So how system will know? We'll see the controls. So we have a standard item which you sell to the customer. There is a text item, brochures, user manuals, flyers, these all things you give it to the customers. And you have value item, TAW. TAW, value item. What is value item? We don't sell this item, but this item has some value. I hope everyone might be using credit cards. Your bank might be sending you some movie tickets, right? Or some dinner passes or shopping coupons, right? So you might be receiving, right, everyone? Is bank's product or movie tickets or shopping coupons? No, right? It's not their products, but they give it to you as a, because you are a loyalty customer. So bank is giving you that as an additional benefit to you, but they don't sell it to you. They just give free of cost. That means we don't sell the product to the customer, but that will have some value. Okay, shopping coupon of $10. So $10 worth of coupon, they are giving it to you free of cost, but they are not selling, right? So that is value item, which we don't sell to customer, but it will have some value. Packing item. See, let's say your company is a laptop manufacturing company or a mobile company. It comes in a very nice, decent packing, right? Is that packing free for the company? Anyone?
No.
Like Apple.
No.
Apple comes in a very decent packing. Is it free? No, right? So that packing will incur some cost to the company. So packing also you should maintain as an item. You will have inventory for packing also, right? So what kind of item it is? That is determined by this field called as item type. Okay, this field will tell what kind of item it is. Standard item, it's blank because this is we sell to the customer. The next is business item. So what is business item? Business item is nothing but, what is business data? Did we discuss? What is business data? Business data is nothing but in the customer master, we have sales. In the sales area data, we have sales, we have shipping, we have billing, and we have partners, right? But except partners. Except partners, what are the fields you see in these particular tabs are called as business data. This is called as business data. And the table for this business data is VBKD. In the interviews also, they ask this question. What is the table for business data? VBKD, right? That means, see, we already discussed that the data from customer master will come at the header level, right? At the header level. But would you like to get this business data to come at the item level? Do you want to allow it or not? That is control it. You activate, you are telling system that you take business data from customer master to item level. If you don't want it, just uncheck it. System will not consider that. Completion rule. Completion rule. What is completion rule? Let's say I created an inquiry for X material 100 quantity. Now I'm creating a quotation with reference to same inquiry for X material 50 quantity. So how much quantity still is remaining in inquiry? Anyone?
50.
In inquiry.
50.
Can I create one more quotation with reference to this inquiry?
For yes.
The balance 50 quantity, can I create?
Yes.
We cannot create. Okay. We cannot create it. Why we cannot create? Because the completion rule was inquiry is first reference. In the first reference, whatever the quantity you referred, that is freezed. That's it. You cannot create, even though there are quantities available, you cannot create one more quotation referring to this because the completion rule for AFN inquiry is first reference. First, whatever you referred, that's it, done. You cannot create one more. Quotation. I created for X material 100 quantity. First, I referred X material 50 quantity. Order. I create an order with reference to this quotation. Can I create one more order?
Yes, you should. Why not?
You can.
Yes. Right? We can, in this case, we can create. Why? Because the completion rule, that means when this quotation document will be complete, when you refer the complete quantity, all the 100 has to be finished, then only it will say complete. Contract, let's say I created a quantity contract for X material 500 quantity, and in the first order, I created release order for X material 250 quantity. So can I create one more?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Because the target quantity has to be completed. Then only a contract will become complete. Right? So how do system knows that there is still some quantity pending in the contract or quotation, whether in the inquiry it will not allow you basing on this completion rule. So if I go for AFN inquiry, the completion rule is A. Quotation B. Right? So what is the completion rule for inquiry? A means item is complete with first reference. You just refer it. What are the quantity? It doesn't matter. It's finished. B, completed only when the full quantity is referred. If it's a quantity contract, full target quantity has to be referred. If it's a value contract, full target value has to be referred. But if I go for TAM, standard item, it is blank. Why it is blank? In the interviews also, they ask this question. Why completion rule is not applicable for TAN? Why it is not applicable for TAN? Because inquiry, with reference to inquiry, I create a quotation. With reference to quotation, I create a sales order. With reference to order, what I create?
Invoice, bill,
delivery. Right?
Delivery.
Is delivery a sales document?
No.
These are the sales document. Completion rule is applicable only for sales document. After the order, delivery is coming. So completion rule is not applicable for order. You take quantity contract. With reference to this, you are creating an order. You take value contract. With reference to this, you're creating an order. So these all are sales documents. So completion rule is applicable for only sales document to sales document. But after order, delivery is coming. That's the reason it is not applicable here. So in the interest of, they ask you why there is no completion rule for TAN, because after order, we create a delivery document, which is not a sales document, so it's not applicable. Okay. Then schedule line allowed. What is schedule line?
Schedule. Confirmed quantity, confirmed dates.
Confirmed quantity plus confirmed delivery date, right? So if I'm buying one laptop, what is the quantity? One. Plus confirmed delivery date, let's say 30 March. Along with the laptop, you will also give user manual, right? Do I need to have a schedule line for user manual?
No need. It goes along with material.
Right? You don't need it because it goes along with the main item. You don't separately deliver it. It is already there in the box. You don't need a schedule line for a text item, right? So where system knows that you don't want a schedule line for a text item or credit memo. Does credit memo have schedule line?
No,
right? No, because for credit memo, there is no delivery at all. Credit memo is order related billing. So how system knows that for credit memo or these scenarios of text item, there is no schedule line that is with this field. So let me create an order and show you. So whatever we are discussing is item category, and as I told you, for a item category is applicable only for that particular item. You see TAN has been come here, right? So if I double click this line item, and you are seeing a button called as schedule lines. If you go to the schedule lines, you are seeing a confirmed delivery date plus confirmed quantity. This is schedule line, right? And this is item category TAN, which you sell to the customer. Along with this, you should also give a user manual. Let's say that 100 is a laptop. Along this, you need to give a user manual. How do you enter the user manual? For user manual, you don't need to maintain material master. You don't have a material master for that. You just directly enter in the description here. So just enter user manual, quantity one, that's it. You see, system has created one extra line. And what is item category? System automatically picks an item category called as TATX. And if I go for TATX, do I have schedule line for TATX here? No. Why there is no schedule line for TATX? Because in TATX item category, schedule line is off. You see? So what is the functionality of this particular schedule line allowed? It will help us to get the schedule lines tab in the sales order. So let's say if for this particular item category TAN standard, I uncheck the schedule line, and if I create an order now, so if I create an order for schedule line, so this is an item category TAN standard. If I go to, you see, there is no schedule line tab, which was there earlier for a TAN. Why its system is not showing here? Because we have unchecked the schedule line for TAN. So this field schedule line will control that whether you will get a schedule line button into the sales document or not. So it is very important for your learning that you should know for which it's not applicable. In the interest also, they ask the same thing. So it is not that you should tell the positive thing, that means for which it is applicable. No, in the interest, they'll ask you, can you tell me two scenarios where schedule line is not applicable? So what are those scenarios? Anyone?
Credit memo.
One is text item.
All these item categories.
Credit memo, text item.
TATX, GTN, L2N, KMN, WKN, all these item categories, it is not allowed. Okay. So see, in the document, everything is very clear for which it is applicable. We already discussed VBKD. We just discussed the completion rule and why it is not applicable for TAN. But everything is perfect. Please read through this. And I already told you, never ignore something which is highlighted. Right? So schedule lines, which it's not applicable for some scenarios which I just shown you. Okay, so it's not applicable, that's fine. But how system is allowing you to do a delivery? Or else you take other scenarios. Bomb, computer. But you also have components, right?
Yeah.
Even for this, you will not have schedule line because they are integral part of main item. You are delivering computer means you are delivering CPU, monitor, and everything, right? So how system is allowing you to do a delivery? Even user manual, how system is allowing you to do a delivery, even though they don't have a schedule line. That is item relevant for delivery. TATX, even though it does not have a schedule line, because see, without a schedule line, you cannot do a delivery because in the schedule line, there is a field called as moment type. See, if I deliver a goods, what happens technically? The material goes out of the plant, right? If customer return the goods, I take back the goods. That means the materials are coming inside the plant. I know that, you know that, but how system will identify it, whether the stock is going outside or coming inside or from one storage location to other storage location, how system will identify with a concept called as moment type. And moment type will be there in the schedule line. So if you don't have a schedule line, if you don't have a moment type, system will not allow you to do a delivery. So you don't have a schedule line here. That means you don't have a moment type, but still how system is allowing you to do these deliveries? Because these items are relevant for delivery. These items are marked as they are relevant for delivery. That's the reason system is allowing you to do the delivery. Then next is returns. All returns, this will be activated. So what all the returns we have? Standard return, REN. Standard return, REN. For every return, this is applicable. So in the SD document category under the VO V8, whatever the documents is having a document category H, this returns will be activated. That is standard return, consignment return, KRN, consignment returns, KAN, consignment pickup, NLR, STO returns. Every returns, whatever the concept you have a return, this should be activated. How system will be identifying whether this item is coming inside or outside and this is a return item? By this checkbox. For TAN standard item, you don't have this activated because it's a positive scenario. The goods would be going out, right? So when you activate this for some item, then system will identify this is a return coming inside the plant. So in the last session, we discussed that we have a field called as credit active. Sorry. We have a field called as credit status or something, right? Where we maintain simple or automatic ABCD. Usually we maintain in a sales document, header and item. In the item, we have three line items, X material 100 quantity, serial number 20, Y material 100 quantity, serial number 30, X, Z material 100 quantity. And credit management will be applicable here. Irrespective of number of item, it will be checked at the sold to party level. But I don't want to perform credit limit to this line item. I don't want to include this item into the credit management. So what I can do? Anyone, can you give me a solution? How can you do that? I don't want to include this item into credit management. So I'll tell you one thing. See, whether you want to include a line, so all the time credit management is performed at the header level, but you can control at the item level. That means which item you want to include into the credit management, which item you don't want to include into credit management, that is controlled by credit active. That means even though you maintain credit management here, but you can control at the item level, you can uncheck this. System will not include this into the credit management. So customer is telling that I have a material called as 30Z, which is a slow moving item. I don't want to this item to be included into credit management. How do you do this? Anyone?
So
uncheck a new item category. I will create a new item category. Copy this TAN and uncheck this right. Field.
So you'll copy this item category ZTAN, and for ZTAN you'll uncheck this, and for this particular item Z, you'll have an item category determination like this OR, norm, no usage, no halal item. I want ZTAN. So for this, you should also change the document type ZOR. And if with this, norm is obviously maintained in the material master, right? If this both are combination, I want this item category to be determined. And for this item category, I don't want credit management. Right? So this is how you can control whether you want to create an item, include an item category into the sales document or not.
Praveen.
Yeah.
Can we only change this norm that is in material master of that particular material?
This is also you can change.
We can maintain is YORM something and leave that OR to be OR itself.
You can do that. You can create a new item category group. Let me show you somewhere we created it. SPRO IMG. I hope we create that in the logistics general. Material master, the material master, basic settings. Do we have it here? No. I don't exactly remember this because we never do it, but somewhere it will be. We can create a new item category group and we can make it sure you can assign it. Access sequence main addition somewhere. I remember it is, it should be somewhere here. Or else let's check in the sales and distribution sales. Okay, yeah, it should be in. Okay, this item category group, whatever in the logistics execution middle master, that is for MM actually, which is assigned to the MRP type. No, for SD it will be in the sales in here itself, sales, in the sales, sales documents, sales item, and item category groups here. Right, so you can create your own new item category and make sure that you assign that particular for your item category determination. So, oh yeah, you can get a new item category into a sales document. Okay, so the earlier part what I have shown, that is for the general item category group. Right, so that's how
and,
you make sure. Yeah.
And Praveen, what about item uses? There is item uses too in determination. Can we change that too for this scenario?
No, item usage is used only for the automatic determination, where system automatically identifies the process.
That means to say we cannot customize an item usage.
It's not about customizing. You can create customization. So why you need to customize item usage when you can go for your own item category determination? Item usage is to identify the standard process. That means free goods. How system identifies automatically a free goods? Because there is item usage called as free. Okay, that is automatic item category determination. When you have an option to create your own item category determination, then why you need to create a new usage? If you want, you can always create, but you don't need it.
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah, so you can go by your own determination. The next is determine cost. What is the condition type for cost? And where do we created cost?
It's in the VPRS.
So condition type is VPRS and we maintain in the material master. That means even though we maintain the cost price in the material master, but unless until you activate this, it will not come into sales document. When you activate this particular determined cost, then only it will come into the sales document. Okay. Then next is special stock indicator. This special stock indicator is applicable only for three business processes. That is IPO, TAB. TAB is the individual purchase order TAB, and for that it will be maintained as E. Special stock indicator E. Make to order TAK. TAK, make to order. It is E. For both the process IPO and make to order, that is TAB and TAK, it is E. Consignments, KEN, consignment issue, it is W. Consignment returns also, it is W, KRN. KRN consignment returns also, it's W. So what does this special stock indicator control? let's see the discuss the scenario. We'll not go into the deep scenario, but let's try to understand how it functions. Okay. Just excuse me a moment, I'll be back right away. So I'll take you through the IPO process, which is same applicable for make to order process as well. Okay, the functionality of special stock indicators applicable same for both the processes. Okay, individual purchase order IPO process. So when we go for individual purchase order, that we take the stock from the vendors, okay, to deliver it to the customers, trading business. So you see here, customer is placing an order to the company. Let's say the customer name is ABC. Customer ABC has placed an order to the company for X material 100 quantity with a order number 103. Order number is 103. He has placed an order for X material 100 quantity and the customer is ABC. So as we don't manufacture this X material and we always get it from the vendor because it's a trading material, we have raised a purchase order to vendor and vendor has delivered this stock to the company. Vendor has delivered this stock to the company, right? So we have done MIGO. MIGO means goods received, taking the materials into the plant against a purchase order, that is goods received. So we have taken this material into the plant, X material 100 quantity. So now you tell me why company has procured this material, X material 100 quantity. What made the company to procure this material from a vendor? Anyone?
Order of the customer and we do not make it.
Order of the?
The customer has ordered this material and we do not manufacture it.
Okay. Let's say this customer has not placed this order. Will you procure this?
No.
No, right? That means this material should be delivered to whom? This material, particular X material 100 quantity, whatever you procured, it should be delivered only to this particular customer ABC against this sales order, right? So there are two special stock indicators. The special stock indicator, first one, you ignore it now because later again we'll discuss. So what system will do when you do MIGO in the IPO process or make to order process, system will reserve the stock against this sales order. System will reserve the stock against this sales order. When it reserved against the sales order, when you are doing a delivery, what stock should be considered? Only the stock which is already reserved against the sales order, right? Only this stock you should consider when you are doing a delivery. How system will know that you should deliver only the stock which is reserved against this particular order you should deliver? Special stock indicator E in the item category TAB and TAK. So what does a special stock indicator control? It controls that in the make to order process and IPO process, whenever you are doing a delivery, you should deliver only the stock which is already reserved against this stock. How to reserve that, we'll see when it comes to the process, right? This is what the functionality of E. Okay.
What is MIGO, Praveen?
That we'll discuss when it comes here. MIGO is nothing but capturing the goods when it comes to the plant. So you ordered some material from a vendor. So vendor has delivered the goods to you. So when you're taking the goods, you need to write it in some books, right? Saying that this much quantity I received against this purchase or this thing, that is called as MIGO, goods received. MIGO is nothing but a T code. MIGO is a T code for goods received. MIRO is a T code for incoming invoices. As a company, we also receive lots of invoices from vendors and suppliers. So how do you capture that incoming invoices? Through MIRO. And how do you capture the goods coming inside the plant? Through MIGO. Okay, they are T codes. Later, once we can discuss the business process, we can discuss more on that. So the next is consignments, the special stock indicator W. Special stock indicator W is applicable for two item categories, KEN and KRN. KRN, both for consignment process. So before going to this, let me just give a small idea about what is consignment process and why these particulars are applicable. In a consignment process, we have two scenarios, positive and negative kind of scenario. Not really a positive negative, but for our better understanding, I'm making it as a positive or negative. So what exactly is a consignment process? That is, let's say Maruti manufactures cars. And for every car Maruti manufactures, it need one battery. Is Maruti manufacturing battery?
No,
right? Maruti don't manufacture battery. Maruti don't manufacture the tires. Tires may be coming from MRF. Battery might be coming from Exide.
Right?
Engine may be coming from pistons. Lot of components are there, right? Auto ancillaries. Lot of auto ancillaries will be coming from different companies. So Maruti is a continuous production line. Every day there they manufacture some 50-100 cars. That means every day they need 100 batteries. If Maruti is manufacturing 100 cars a day, it needs 100 battery a day. Or else you take tires, MRF. If Maruti is manufacturing 100 cars a day, that means it need into 400 tires every day, right? It's a continuous production line. So to not to have any hiccups in the delivery, what in this particular scenario we do is, we try to maintain some stock at customer location. MRF will dump some 10,000 tires at customer location. Our Exide will dump, say, 50,000 batteries at customer location. So that we are trying to make sure that the stock is available as close as to possible to the customer. If he want, he should immediately consume it. He should not again raise a order. We should deliver it, right? Because see, if you don't get tires on time, what happens? Maruti sub production line will be stopped, right? Any one part of this particular is missing, the production line will be stopped, right? It can be any, you know, that there can be political uncertainties, there can be natural calamities, there can be some transport issues. For any reason, there can be a late in the delivery. So there will be an issue, right? So not to have this kind of issue, companies, what they do is they maintain certain stock at the customer location. They can consume it. Even though MRF has dumped 10,000 tires at Maruti location, who is the owner of these 10,000 tires? Who is the MRF. Owner of these 10,000 batteries?
MRF batteries.
MRF.
Companies are owners.
Companies are the owners, right? See, we are only dumping the stock at customer location. When he consume it, we bill it. Even though the stock is at customer location, the owner is the company itself, until unless they consume it and we bill it. So this all process is called as OEM process in the automobiles, original equipment manufacturer. In every business, you will see OEMs. You take a Dell laptop. Dell has Intel processor, right? So, but the name will not be wiped off. When you buy Maruti car, the tires still say MRF. The batteries say Exide. When you buy a Dell laptop, it says Intel. They don't wipe off the name because they are the original equipment manufacturers, right? So this is one scenario where you want to put this material very close to your customer. This is positive scenario of your consignments. There is also a negative scenario of a consignment. As I told you, it's not really a positive negative. For our best understanding, I'm telling that. So Maruti manufacturing cars. In Maruti, there is a model called as A-Star. You know it?
Yes.
Right? Is it success?
No. That much, not that much.
Right, it is not that success by model, look, whatever it is, the reason, this is not that successful. But Maruti has invested a lot of money in production line or in the design comp, these all things. They want to sell it, or they have some dead stock of 1,000 cars. They want to get rid of the stock because, see, in the plant, 1,000 cars occupying the space. Just imagine how much space they will be taking. And new cars are manufactured and they need space to park them, right? So they want to push these cars out of the plant. But no customer is ready to take. That means no dealer is ready to take. Why no dealer is not ready to take? No end user is not, no end customer is ready to buy them, right? So now company comes with a consignment concept. What is consignment concept? You take the stock, don't pay me anything, okay? See, usually if you want to take stock, at least upfront you need to pay something, right? 10%, 5%, so upfront you need to pay something. But in this consignment process, You take the stock without paying any upfront money. You pay me when only you sell this car to end customer. Only when you sell it, you pay me the money. Until then, you don't pay me. You take the stock. Got the idea? So here, what's happening? We are pushing out this material out of the plant, okay, to make space for the new materials. Or this is a dead stock. You want to get rid of this dead stock. But what is the advantage dealer is getting here? Anyone? What advantage a dealer would be getting out of this scenario?
No investment. I mean,
right?
No investment. So without, after sales only has to pay.
Yeah. So without paying anything, he's getting stock, and his portfolio line is also increased, right? So that is one advantage a dealer would be getting, high commissions as well, right? This is consignment, another like negative kind of process where companies want to get rid of the old stocks. So in this process, so total consignment is of total four processes. Consignment, fill up, sorry, consignment, fill up. That is the first process. Item category is KBN. KBN is the item category. In this process, what we do is we debit the stock from unrestricted stock and deliver to the customer, that is dealer. And at the dealer level, we maintain a consignment stock. That means stock will be debited from unrestricted stock and stock will be posted into consignment stock. What is this particular consignment stock, unrestricted stock? That you will learn in the next session when moment type comes. Okay. I hope it would be better, make sense when we discuss at the time of moment type. Okay. We'll do one thing. We'll stop this particular W today because it makes more sense. Yeah.
Can you repeat last 30 seconds, whatever you said, because your voice was not coming right.
So what exactly you missed? Because 30 seconds.
I missed that debit or credit while you were telling about the stock.
Okay. So in consignment, what happens is the stock will be debited from the unrestricted stock and stock will be posted into consignment stock. Okay. So what is debiting of consignment stock and how it is posting? It's better we will discuss in the schedule line part, not in the item category, because their moment type comes and it makes more sense to discuss at that time rather than now. But just make a note that KEN and KRN consignment processes will have a special stock indicator W. So what is this W and what is the effect of the moment types? We will discuss at the time of schedule lines. That makes more sense there. Okay. Then next is the billing relevance, again relevant to what you bill the customer, and the billing plan type, that is periodic billing or milestone billing. Yeah, this field pricing is more important. So we just discussed that you are selling a material called as X. For 1X, $100. Okay, 1X material is $100. So the scenario in the business is for every X material 100 quantity, the business is issuing 20 X materials as free. How system knows that the 20 material is free? That is our TATX, text item. You are not charging anything. How system knows you should not charge for that item? That is with this field called as pricing. TAM, standard item, you sell to the customer. X means standard item. You have to charge for this. TATX, text item. You see, this field itself is grayed out. There is no option of price. Free goods, TANN. You should not charge for this. How system knows that the same material which you sell, but now you give it for free? How system knows? It's a free of charge item, 100% discount. 100% discount, free of charge, right? So with this system, it'd be not charging for that X material, whichever you're selling for the customer, right? Then next is statistical. This statistical value is applicable only for one scenario, that is a bomb item. Bomb item is TAE, TAE. You see, only TAE, this is applicable, bomb. So what is the statistical means? Computer, right? So you have
have subcomponents, CPU, you have mouse, you have keyboard, and these all things, right? So the computer price is 20K. How this 20K has come? 5K each component, right? And keyboard, mouse, monitor, right? 5K. So when you're delivering this item should become statistical. If they are not statistical, system will take the same price. And if I say I sold 100 computers, what do you mean by that? I sold 100 CPUs, 100 mouse, 100 keys, and 100 monitor, right? So I need to have this all inventory. Right? So how it be calculated with this statistical value? That's the reason it is applicable only for the BOM item, BOM sub items. So that is statistical value. Order quantity is equal to one. So you'll also be seeing on Amazon, Flipkart, any new product is launched. For one order, only one quantity you can order, not more than that. If this material is something like that, you can just activate this order quantity is equal to one. Rounding permitted. This rounding is volume rounding. Some items will have some milligrams or some ounce differences. Would you like to round it to the nearest value? Yes, rounding is permitted, right? So that you can control here. So we'll stop it here and we'll continue other fields tomorrow. We'll finish this tomorrow. We'll finish item categories as well. We will also start schedule lines tomorrow. Okay. So any questions out of this?
Sir, this tomorrow we are to discuss how the item category defines like that, sir. My question.
Yes.
Is
item category determination is how the item categories will come into sales document.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
We are talking about tables in the process, but how we use the tables?
Can you repeat?
We are talking about tables today also you told about
BBKD, these tables,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay, when you go for the functional specification, you will be knowing that, but if you want to see some table, SC16N. FC16N and just pass that particular table name. Okay, so VBKD. Okay, these are the fields: pricing group, customer group, sales district, price list, import terms. These all fields we have seen at the customer master level, right? So yes. This is VBKD. So whatever we payment terms, extra additional value days, account assignment group of customer, exchange rate. As I mentioned, what are the three you see the fields in the tabs? They are called as VBKD. And these are the technical field name of each field. If you want to see the data, just execute. You'll see the data in each field, what it is maintained. Okay. This at the time of functional specification, you will get a complete idea how to use this. Okay. But if you want to see any table like this and you want to get a data, just go through SC16N and pass on that particular table and say execute. Any questions?
Praveen, yesterday you told to give some variant configuration docs and status profile document, how to maintain that. Will you please share that today?
Yeah, sure.
And one more document, Praveen. You shown ticket document to us in initial sessions. I want that document, right? I mean, please share that too.
You are applying for jobs now? You're applying for jobs?
No, not applying, Praveen, but I want to actually see what real time issues are and scenarios are. Accordingly, plan.
See, don't worry about those documents as of now. Don't waste your time. So the more documents you have, the more you will be confused. Okay. My recommendation is stick to whatever you are doing, because as in day passes, we are adding lots of subject. So why I'm not sharing the documents now? Because if nothing goes right. So only the reason is I don't want you to juggle between these all documents and get depressed. Once you see the documents, you'll go into depression. You'll feel that, can I do it or not? Don't worry about those things. If you want, I can share it. Keep them, but just put it aside. Don't go through them. Okay?
Okay, okay.
Whatever the documents you have, they are much more than enough as of day. As it's passing, I'll be sending you lots of documents you need to go through. So SHD00, that variant, I'll send you a document, right? And in tomorrow session, I'll send you moment times. Later, I'll send pricing. Lots of documents I'll be sending you. So let's go phase wise. There's no purpose of collecting and putting all the documents. Okay. Don't worry. I'll be sending every document whenever it is required to you. I don't want you to like be nervous by seeing them. Yeah. Any other question?
Regarding that demo session of SAP HANA, I still receive it. I didn't receive any emails
for that. For the HANA?
Yes. Yes, for it.
Okay. I'll send you tomorrow.
Okay.
I mean, how about the video 17, the class 17 video? Still on HANA? It's already uploaded.
Yes. Check it. I remember it is uploaded. Check in the drive. I remember it's uploaded. Okay. Yeah. So just let me know if it's not uploaded. I'll re-upload it. I remember it's uploaded. So let's call it a day today. Catch up tomorrow. And tomorrow we'll go with this item category and item category determination tomorrow. And we'll also start schedule lines. Right. So see you all and catch up tomorrow. Bye-bye.